Welcome back. Let's play some Life is Strange. It's a story-based game that features player choice. The consequences of all your in-game actions and decisions will impact past, present, and future. Wait, how do your decisions impact the present? The present's just a fleeting instant. Far be it for me to ask questions, right? We had one heck of a storm yesterday, but nothing like this. I'm just amazed at this storm. What could have possibly caused this? And there's the lighthouse. Dang. It might not be safe at the lighthouse. Yeah, maybe you should be seeking shelter. I don't know where. Holy moly. Little pieces of Tata. But he could be talking about the Tata.
Okay, I'm in class. Everything's cool. I'm okay.
To Shadow. From color to Kirsky. Now, can you give me an example of a photographer who perfectly captured the human condition in
life? I didn't fall asleep, and that sure would feel like a dream. Weird.
Arbus.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Because of her images of hopeless faces. You feel like totally haunted by the eyes of those sad mothers and children.
She saw humanity as torture, right? And frankly, it's bullshit.
Shh,
keep it to yourself. Seriously though, I could frame any one of you in a dark corner and capture you in a moment of desperation. And any one of you could do that to me. Isn't that too easy? Too obvious? What if Arbus chose to capture people at the height of their beauty or innocence? She had a burning eye, so she could have taken another approach.
I have to admit, I'm not a big fan of her work. I prefer Robert Frank.
Me too, Victor. He captured the essence of post-war beat America, and there was honesty about the economic conditions of the era, but a beauty in the struggle. You don't have beauty without a beat. Which explains why Frank was Kerouac's photographic muse, and both were the great chroniclers of the 1950s. Well,
man, I'm learning a lot.
Shot of Kerouac on the balcony. And if you haven't, shame, shame. capturing the romantic urban solitude of the 20th century poet.
Do you... You did. Wait, I want to see that. Now, can you show me that? Please?
Salvador Dali's surrealist photographs. Like Cocteau, he was a true Renaissance man. And his famous...
Also, what kind of college lecture is this?
Kids love so much. The selfie. And it's a great tradition, and I wholeheartedly fight for your right to self-expression. Or selfie expression. Sorry, I know. So if anybody wants to question the portrait as modern narcissism, they could go back hundreds of years to blame society.
Well, sure.
I bet you thought I'd talk all the way to the line. It's your turn to lecture us. Now, based on the chapters, I have no doubt you all memorized. Who can tell me the name of the actual process that led to the birth of the self-portrait?
Victoria. Come on, Victoria, you can do it.
Anybody? This does not bode well.
Louise Daguerre. Just a guess. All right, let's take a look at this.
How can I show this to Mr. Jefferson? I can hear the class laughing at me now.
Oh. Well, that's kind of pathetic. Wait, can I look at this other thing?
Just jump right in with an answer.
I can't believe I still have this pencil case. I should upgrade to the 21st century. But I like it also. If anybody else looked at this, what would they think?
October 1. October, my favorite month. The best weather of the year. I love watching the leaves change color, turning into tiny flames. But it's still too damn hot. And I still can't bust out the big coats and sweaters or scary movies yet. Soon, Kate will let me borrow The October Country by Red Bear Bradbury. I haven't read much by him, which caused Warren to almost revoke my geek cred before I held up my copy of Battle Royale. But he nails the autumn atmosphere of small towns. I'd actually use the word autumnal just to sound cool and smart, but fine. The last time I wore a Halloween costume was with Chloe. I have pictures in one of my old albums. I should find a real Halloween party to crash so I can find some social mingling. It's that or a Vortex Club Stroke Fest swimming party. Or is that Backstroke Fest? You're so funny. At least I'm trying to climb out of my cocoon. I shouldn't expect my life to completely change over a few weeks at Blackwell Academy. As my parents love telling me on a loop, you have all the time in the world. Wait, why did I skip to page 8? Is that just where my diary was open to? Let's start this at the beginning. I got accepted into Blackwell Academy! If words could dance, this would be a rave. Even though I've never got into one. But who cares, because I got into Blackwell. I didn't think I would be so excited, since it's not like I didn't used to live in the same town. But when I saw the text from the Blackwell Scholarship Office, I could literally feel my pulse speed up. I thought it was going to say, sorry, thanks for playing. It took me a few seconds before I read the whole thing. I guess I wanted to enjoy that last moment of blissful ignorance. And when I saw the first word, congratulations, I think I screamed. My mom cried and my dad laughed. They're so weird. But they're happy, and this means extra financial support because they don't have to pay anything to Blackwell. This means new clothes, and if I can work it, a new laptop. Oh, and I have to keep telling myself in caps that I am going to Blackwell Academy. So this is it. I'm leaving Seattle to go back to Arcadia Bay. Usually people go to the high school closest to home. I suppose I am too. It's just I haven't lived there for 5 years. Out of all the photography programs in the world, I choose to go back to the smallest back in a town I was excited about leaving. Maybe I wanted to come back all along just to see if Chloe and I were still even friends. But I do wish Chloe could have moved with me to Seattle. The city was made for her. When we would play pirates in our rooms and in the woods, it seemed like Seattle was that fabled faraway island of treasure and adventure that we were always seeking, with coffee shops. but Seattle wasn't like a fable. Au contraire. Now, Blackwell Academy seems more exotic to me than any other place in the world. To study photography under Mark Jefferson. Insert hearts and flowers. Plus, there'll be cool, diverse students from everywhere. It won't be like my high school now. I never really found a groove with my classmates, or boys. I'm lucky I have a couple great friends here, but it's going to take time to ship out. Oh, I'm sorry, but it's time to ship out. So maybe Arcadia Bay will actually turn out to be the island of treasure and adventure I've been looking for. Shit be crazy here. I didn't realize how much crap I had to pack until I had to pack. Mom and Dad are getting a little excited about cleaning out my room. Though, I caught Mom crying when she was packing my shirts. That made me want to cry like a little girl and never leave Seattle. So instead of packing, I feel like burning all my clothes, then just raiding a thrift store to help build up a new Max wardrobe over my junior year. Not that I even have an old Max wardrobe. No one will know me except for Chloe, and who knows how different we are now, so I guess I can cut my hair, get a tat, and some piercings, maybe date a cute foreign exchange artiste from Paris or Rome. I can do anything, unless I get busted. There'll be so many super cool chances for my photography to get exposed. Thinking about that is when I get scared, but excited, and I don't feel like crying at all. I get tingles down my arms, sensing the universe opening up to me. I can't wait to leave. I just want things to be different at Blackwell. My first entry from my new dorm room the night before my first day at Blackwell. Phew! I hadn't had any time to write or even take pictures since I got here. My shit's in boxes all over the room, which is small but mine, and I never want to leave. I can't wait to decorate. I'll have a whole wall of photos. I did meet some of my dorm mates, though I suck at remembering names, so I won't bother right now. But I think I can already see who's going to be cool to me and who's not. It's a bitch trying to get settled into a new school and social scene after I finally found some good friends in Seattle. But I'm here now, and this is the start of my new life. Sweet dreams. Blackwell sucks. I told myself not to whine so soon, but damn. The day started like Christmas morning. I barely had any dreams because I was so pumped to start my first official day in my new life. Like a dork, I couldn't figure out what to wear, so I chose what was on the floor. I'm no good with names and faces right away, but I picked up some names like Kate Brooke, Taylor Alyssa. And how could I forget Victoria Chase? Rich, stylish, entitled. I could feel instant judgment when she looked at my raggedy-ass clothes. As if I'm at Blackwell to strike fashion poses? Maybe I'm being extra crispy sensitive, but I think Victoria wants life here to be her own reality show. Ugh. So that wasn't fun, along with my general social unease. And thought it would be easier being back. Call the Wambulance. I don't want this day to end all woe is Max. It was incredible to walk across the green campus in the morning mist. I love the stone steps and brick walls at Blackwell. Everything is a picture waiting to be taken. Speaking of, at least one great thing did happen today. Mr. Jefferson's photography class. Sigh. There's more to tell. Forgive me, I'm truly wiped out. Yes, I'm gonna spend, like, pages explaining, okay, all the drama, and how this class was so great. And not going to tell you anything more. I have an ass load of homework already. So much bullshit. At least give us noobs a day to acclimate. To prove I'm not a total loser, I made a new friend in my science class. His name's Warren Graham, and he's a serious geek. Plus, he's dark and witty. He comes across as kind of a know-it-all. But he does know a lot. We talked about photographers, and he actually named a few I've never heard of. We traded numbers, and he'll be a good study partner, or a good friend. I'll need at least one based on the click action here. I thought being 18 meant I didn't have to deal with this teenage drama anymore. I thought. At least I get to research famous photographers for some of my homework. Mr. Jefferson assigned us a ton of reading, but this is exactly what I wanted to study. Jefferson is super cool and super chill. He doesn't try to be too hip. just what he says, what he thinks, and expects us to as well. I think he's a genius. Oh my god, I want to marry him. Just joking. This one class is worth all the social dysfunction. Yeah, that does not sound healthy, honestly. And you can't just have one thing which balances out everything else in your life against that one thing. That's just not a healthy way to go. Okay, here we go. Homework's kicking my ass, but the teachers grade harder just to stop you from feeling special. Victoria Chase and her snob minions still front like they're honored guests at Blackwell. The bros here aren't that different. Victoria Prescott, or Nathan Prescott, is Victoria's male clone, with way more money and attitude, if that's even possible. His family is the oldest in Arcadia Bay, and I heard stories about them when I was a kid. The Prescott's give a shitload of bank to Blackwell, so Nathan acts like he literally owns the school. Yesterday during class, he put his feet up on the desk, started texting, and the teacher didn't say jack. I'd get suspended, but him and Victoria are part of the silly elite Vortex Club that puts on popular parties, and so they get their way. It's good to be the king and queen. I don't want to slam everybody. I do like Kate Marsh. She's down the hall in one of my classes. She's so pretty and sweet and friendly. It makes her more beautiful than all the biatches here, like Victoria, who think beauty is just in your face and outfit. Oh, I'm sorry. Let me reread that. It makes her more beautiful than biatches here like Victoria, who think that beauty is just your face and your outfit. See? I'm already playing their drama games. No more. Finally had a chance to take some actual shots around campus today. September 23rd. Bear in mind, we got here September 2nd or... Yeah. So, it took us 21 days to be able to take some actual shots. Such as being 18, I suppose. A perfect blue sky today. I always forget how great I feel after I take pictures when I've been slacking off. Speaking of pictures, Mr. Jefferson told us about the National Everyday Heroes photo contest he wants us all to enter. The winner gets a trip to San Francisco and lots of publicity. He just wants one photograph from each student. It's exactly why I wanted to come to Blackwell, and of course I'm scared shitless to enter. At least I have a couple weeks before the deadline in October. And, you know, considering that it took me 21 days to take a single photo, I should be able to come up with, you know, a photo in the next 2 weeks, right? At the rate of 3 weeks per photo and 14 days until the contest ends. Well, I can't do math, but... You know, I've got plenty of time to stress and procrastinate. I don't know whether I love or hate it here. I'm trying to keep up with my science class, of all things. Like, I give a shit or even understand it. Good thing I know Warren. Too bad I can't clone him to take my place in class. At least I don't think I can. Miss Grant is so much cooler than the class. She explains particle physics, so even boneheads like me can kind of understand how she relates... Punctuation is nice. She explains particle physics, so even boneheads like me can kinda understand. I love how she relates society to science and vice versa. I can tell she's committed and passionate about life, unlike some of us in her class, but I'm trying to engage more, even if it means just asking actual questions in class instead of hiding in the back. Wait, there's a back? Well, I guess in the science class there might be. I'm just glad I'm not the only social misfit here. Now, how much homework are you avoiding? October, my favorite month. Best weather of the year. I love watching the leaves change color, turning into tiny flames, but it's still too damn hot, thanks global warming, and I can't bust out the big coats and sweaters or scary movies yet. Soon Kate will allow me to borrow The October Country by Ray Bradbury, hopefully before November. And hopefully, I'll get my photos taken for that contest, you know, before that happens. I haven't read much by Ray, which caused Warren to almost revoke my geek cred before I held up my copy of Battle Royale. But he nails the autumn atmosphere of small towns. The last time I wore a Halloween costume was with Chloe. I have pictures in one of my old albums. I've been here a month. Anyway, I should find a real Halloween party to crash. You know, 30 days from now. I've got like a week until this contest ends, but I'm worrying about a Halloween party when, you know, people are gonna want me. At least they should. I should have the self-esteem to say, you know, people want me to go to their parties. I'm gonna get invited, and even if I don't, finding one shouldn't be a big challenge. But I should find a real Halloween party to crash, so I can experience some social mingling. Is that or a Vortex Stroke Fest swimming party? Or is that Backstroke Fest? You're so punny, Max. At least I'm trying to climb out of my cocoon. I shouldn't expect my life to completely change after a few weeks at Blackwell Academy. As my parents love telling me on a loop, you have all the time in the world. Alright, that's my diary.
This was in the chapters you read.
Yeah. No, I know. I read the chapters. Just stressing out a little bit. Whoops. Okay, let's try that. Can I look at that?
I should take a quick picture of you.
Sure, why not? Class is talking about selfies. Let's take one.
I believe Max has taken what you kids call a
selfie.
A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max, as a gift. Of course, as you all know, the photo portrait has been popular since the early 1800s. Your generation is not the first to use images for selfie expression. Sorry, I couldn't resist. The point is that the portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for as long as it's been around. Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portrait?
The Daguerrean process.
I did know, but I kind of forgot.
You either know this or not, Max. Is there anybody here who knows their stuff?
Louis Daguerre was a French painter who created daguerreotypes, a process to give portraits a sharp, reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in an Eurozone. Sad face.
Sad face.
The Daguerrean process brought out fine detail in people's faces, making them extremely popular from the 1800s on. The first American daguerreotype self-portrait was done by Robert Cornelius.
Huh.
You can find out all about it in your textbook.
Now, I want this textbook. Can I please have this textbook?
You guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get in together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Okay. Are all art teachers like that? Just that up in your face and stuff?
Victoria doesn't waste a second kissing ass. Kate looks so sad and quiet today.
Kate.
Kate, I hope I didn't embarrass you with my lame answers.
It sucks to be dragged into the spotlight.
Unless you're Victoria.
She's got nothing on you, Max. Well, I should get going.
Keep going, doing what?
Talk to you later.
Sure.
Yeah. Yeah, you should get going and stop moping about. Wait. Okay, I can look at said paper
wall. I wish I wouldn't have read this.
That's not cool.
Obviously, Blackwell spent the bank on computers here.
Obviously. Because, you know, that's really advanced technology right there. Huh. What kind of art manipulation software is that supposed to be? Guess there's nothing I can do with it.
That person
let me stick my camera in there and oh wait. I've got a Polaroid camera. I mean, is this some kind of advanced printer? I can't really tell. I guess it's a photo printer, which I guess I, the protagonist, Max or Maxine, think is pretty amazing. Carbon fiber? Yeah, you are.
That was amazing when Mr. Jefferson took the class picture the first week. Even though I didn't want to be in the picture at all, it was fairly fucking cool to watch him at work bring us.
Wait, where's Kate in the picture? Oh, there she is, in the back right. Kind of obscured by the glare. Anything else to see back here?
So cool to see Mr. Jefferson's actual published pictures. Gives me hope.
Okay. A to read. Yeah, I guess Mr. Jefferson is kind of into noir, just darker films or pictures.
Even her school books are gift wrapped. I can't believe she made fun of me in class. Of course, Victoria has to have the bestest, meanest, most expensive everything.
That's okay. If you say so.
She'll have better equipment than Blackwell.
Dang. Wait, what's the... I don't get it. It shoots what you want, where you want, straight out of the camera. JPEG images already have a superb quality, including a new level of depth, sharpness, and malleability. Really? Yeah, that's really technical. Well, I guess there is a specifications button, so it could actually tell you more about it. That's pretty funny. Just as an engineer of sorts, I find those specs less than impressive. Let's see, is there anything over here?
Whoa, Mr. Jefferson is not messing around with that monster. He probably paid $20,000 for that camera.
For that thing? Are you kidding? $20,000 for a camera like that one? No, seriously.
Whoa, Mr. Jefferson does not mess around with that monster.
Well, apparently.
He probably paid $20,000 for that camera. I bet he gets pristine digital images. But I still did not want instant camera.
Oh, digital images. Okay. I could see for maybe a digital camera blowing that much. And not really understanding what you're getting.
The forest around here always looks mysterious.
Okay. Yeah, it's mysterious, I guess. Let's see. Let's butt in on this.
Every time I look at Victoria, I feel like she's talking smack
about her. Well, yeah, because everything in your universe is all about you.
This is ridiculous.
Really?
I never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in your pictures.
Do I have to? I just don't think it's that big a deal.
Really?
You're a better photographer than a lot.
Yeah.
I know it's a drag to hear some old dude lecture, but life won't wait for you to play catch up. You're young, the world is yours, blah, 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 right? But you do have a gift. You have the fever to take images, to frame the world only the way you.
Can you tell me anything about this way? No, seriously. Offer some criticism that's beyond you, the way you want to view the world, you, something, something, you. That looks beautiful. Wait, Can I get a... Yeah, that looks... That's pretty nice. I wish I could stand right next to the window and look outside it. Let me try for this other window. Wait. There's something over here.
This might make a cool shot.
I wonder if there's one photo worth taking in each scene.
I like this panorama from the black hole. Everything looks so green here.
Yeah, I wish you could like stand outside the window and take a picture from right there. That'd look awesome.
Just I like this panorama from the
see, there's the contrast in the scenery here. And the contrast of the people and just how they look. There's a lot of diversity in color in the photo. Well, I don't know. Let's actually go outside. Right? Hey, look, a TV.
Man, he even has the best plasma HDTV for a class monitor. Can't wait to watch some more documentaries on this bad boy.
What? So he's got a laptop, he's got a TV, he's got a camera, and yet he just lectures.
Mr. Jefferson really expects me to enter.
I guess that's what it's like at a private school. Are you an everyday hero? Find out. Enter to win. Everyday Heroes Photo Contest. Submit an image that best represents yourself or others in the heroic action. Deadline, 1 week from today, plus a day. The winner will fly to San Francisco and represent their school in the National Everyday Heroes Competition, the Zeitgeist Gallery, on October 11th, 2013. You may submit one image on approved paper for consideration. For those 18 and under, a parent, well, wait, 18 and under? Okay. A parent permission form must be included with the image. That's an interesting technicality. So many details. Let's open.
You didn't tell me how cute I looked yet.
I was about to.
Welcome to the green room.
Oh, you silly people. Also, can I just say that those lockers look very much like those you'd see at a public school. I think normally in a private school you'd see like a double wide locker that's not necessarily that high. I mean, you could have a full height double wide locker, but yeah, these seem to be... Oh. Wait, no. Okay, now this is weird. I mean, yeah, in public school you might have either this or something twice as high but this width. And I guess I would expect in a private school that you get like a locker twice that width. So what do we got here? Missing from Arcadia Bay. Rachel Amber, age 19, height 5'5", weight 110, blonde and hazel. Okay. Of course, the phone numbers have 555, as is done in every game. Wait, I want to look at the other thing. Can I? Yeah. Yep. Yeah, if you say it's the portal to Warren's brain, I guess. Okay, way to get involved in the social drama. Can we just go outside? I want to take some pictures. If we can't, is there anything else we can do? Oh. I was going to try to exploit some physics glitches or something. The game doesn't really allow you...
His photos are very cool.
Game doesn't really allow you to do very much. So I'm gonna open it so everybody can see it inside.
Hello, Jack. Kiss, kiss. And a little...
What? Okay. Well, that's special. Yeah, I guess if you're this socially awkward, you do put in headphones and just walk around ignoring everybody. That's pretty awkward, though. Oh, yeah. Clearly, those posters are just going to stop all the evil in the world. We talk to you. Come on. Maybe she's just being as awkward as you are. You ever think about that? You probably didn't. There's another Rachel Amber poster. I keep getting the A and B buttons mixed up. But somebody really must care about Rachel Amber. Oh yeah. Yeah, gun-free zone. That's gonna solve everything. We talk to you. Okay, if you like Miss Grant so much, can you just, like, take out the headphones and talk with her?
I hate these posters. They're so sad.
Yeah.
How many students ever actually memorize all this shit?
What do you mean, memorize this? This is a map. This is used for locating stuff. I mean, I'm sure the students know where the restrooms are. I'm sure they know where the cafeteria is. Beyond that, who's going to bother remembering where room 111 and 114 and 110 and so forth are at? I do find it funny that the science classroom is labeled science class. Like, and then there's the art classroom labeled art class. So, I don't know. Maybe I'm used to things being a little more do-it-yourself in terms of finding things on a map.
There's the lighthouse.
Oh yeah, let's come see the light. Join the Church of Scientology. Or whatever church. So let's see. Is there anything else to see up here? Someone tore down a poster. What's the point? Best singer ever in Oregon looking for a best guitarist ever. Yeah, I'm gonna ignore that. Sad? Only depressed? Come praise with your peers, because you know, if you're sad, let's go be happy being sad. Yeah, that's a great idea. And then there's Swim Like an Otter. Experienced, retired PE teacher and former otter champion would personally train you to glide through the water and embrace your inner otter. For details, contact Michelle Barenci at waterlogged@arcadiabaygym.wet. Yeah, .wet, not a valid domain. Yeah. Like new tablet for sale. Contains 5 gigabytes of cat pics. Oh yeah. Yeah. Wait. Is Mark Jefferson selling a laptop? That has 5 gigabytes of... Okay. Never mind. Oh yeah. Schools sure know what's important. Well, it's good to have, I don't know. It's good to have sports other than football recognized. Can I walk through? No, I can't walk through you either. Nor can I go outside. So I suppose I need to do what the game was wait. One thing. I completely ignored this dude. Can we talk with him? Maybe. I suppose I cannot. So let's go do what the game was telling us to do. Which is Look for a bathroom. So there's one bathroom. Can I find the other one? Or is the other one, like, not accept? Wait. There should be two bathrooms, right? I just want to know. Where's the other bathroom? Okay, so now it should be, like, right in the middle of this. Yeah, right across from the girls' room. I'm just curious. Just want to know. Ah, there it is. I see it. Yep, there's the missing person poster. Coming soon. Okay, it's not gonna let me try to enter. So I suppose I will need to conform with gender identities. Here we go. Oh, thank goodness that music ended. Can I go back out and... I guess not. I'm stuck. Trapped forever in the bathroom. Oh well. It was a good game.
Just relax. Stop torturing yourself. You have a gift. Fuck it.
Really?
When the door closes, the window opens. Or something like that.
I love Victoria Chase. Said that on the wall. Yep. Yeah, let's not tempt fate. Let's just, like, go to the bathroom like you said we're intending to do. Can I do that? I did splash some water on my face, feeling a little bit more awake and alert and stuff.
I feel like the universe is taunting everywhere I go today. It all started with that bizarre dream. Am I going crazy?
Yes. I mean, maybe.
The last time I got a flu shot, I got the flu. Fuck you.
That's not how immunizations work, Max. I mean, you might have some personal experience, but that's not how they work. There are other risks, but getting the flu is not one. Wait, what? Okay. Somebody does not like Kate Marsh. Somebody seriously does not like Kate.
This poster must drive people to have sex.
Wait, can I look at this?
I'm good to flow. Thanks.
You sure? You never know. Never know what you might need when you're gonna need it. Oh wait, what? What did I just step on? Just sworn something weird happened when I stepped over. Yeah. So apparently I can just step on these rolls here. And not crush them. Can I check these other doors? Ew. Yeah, seriously, who would do that? Other than maybe me. Alright, Oh, a fire bell. Let's take a look at
I
that.
I remember when somebody pumped the alarm last month. At least I got out of science class with our quiz. Whoa, where did that butterfly come from?
I don't know.
This is like any kind I've ever seen before. The blue wings are practically...
else to save him?
Almost like a spirit.
Go on. Now tell me more about this butterfly. Okay, fine. We shall take a photo. A better way to capture the moment than with a photo. Dude, wrong bathroom.
Don't stress, you're okay, bro. Just come to three. Don't be scared. You own this school. I want it. I could blow it up. You're the boss.
No, seriously, dude. Wrong bathroom.
So what do you want?
I hope you check the perimeter, as my step-ass would say. Now, let's talk business.
I got nothing for you.
Oh.
You got hella cash.
That's my family.
I now understand.
Oh, boo-hoo, poor little rich kid. I know you've been pumping drugs and shit to kids around here. I bet your respectable family would help me out if I went to them. Man, I can see the headlines now.
Leave them out of this bitch.
I can tell everybody. Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself.
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing with.
Whoa.
Come on, put that thing down.
Ever tell me what to do. I'm so sick of people trying to control me.
You're going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
That got away from you, psycho.
No.
Holy moly. Well, damn.
Whoa. What the fuck? How can that be?
Whoa.
In the bathroom, he shot that poor girl. I held up my hand, and then I was back here. And if Victoria's phone rings, this is real.
Now, can you give me an example of a
I cannot believe this.
Human conditioning, black and white.
Okay, if I'm crazy, I might as well go all the way. Can I actually move the first time?
Nope.
Why are you?
Because of our images of hopeless faces. You feel like totally haunted by that.
Oh, really? I'm forced to? Really? Okay, I guess I have no choice. Yeah, let's go full crazy. What's the worst that could happen with that?
I did it. I actually did it.
Perfectly captured.
Damn.
Anybody?
Max, don't freak out. Not yet.
Why are you?
Does this work?
Together, Max. You feel like totally haunted by the eyes of
I took my selfie. Jefferson asked me a question. If he does again, I'll know this is for real.
Oh yeah, now I'll know it's for real.
A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. Madness. That's a gift.
I know I'm not dreaming this. It's real. I can tell.
Wait, how do you know this isn't a dream?
So I can go back in time.
Selfie expression.
What if that
I mean,
can I say something?
Has always been a vital aspect of art and photography.
I need to go to the bathroom quickly and check it out.
Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self portrait?
I'm sorry. I feel sick. May I be excused?
Nice try, Max. But you're not going to get away that easy. We can talk to you after class.
Boo. That sucks.
And I need time to save that girl.
Yep. Like a mirror. I'm totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria.
What if I don't remind you? I'm giving you an answer.
Well, I guess we gotta do what we gotta do, right?
Now, Max, since since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portrait?
Yeah, I used to know, but I forgot. Either that or the Daguerreian process. Invented by a French painter named Louis Daguerre around 1830.
Somebody has been reading as well as posing. Nice work, Max. The Daguerreian process made portraiture hugely popular, mainly because it gave the subjects clearly defined features. You can learn more when you actually finish reading the assigned chapters. Max is so far way ahead of everyone. Guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out
blah, blah, blah,
to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and you can kickstart a career in photography. So
what does he mean, feted by the art world?
Don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see.
Max,
wait.
You're not crazy.
I thought last time you said something about Victoria.
It's time to be an everyday hero.
Alright, let's go be a hero.
I see you, Max Caulfield. Don't even think about leaving here until we talk about your entry.
Okay, fine. Let's talk about my entry.
I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing any entry.
Yeah. I'm not sure I'd have fun.
Yeah, that's not gonna fly.
Sure you must have about 1,000 pics by now.
It'll take a long time to find a good one.
Max,
you got a week.
Don't wait too long. John once said that life is what happens while busy making other plans. Go on, don't let me stop you.
Well, that was satisfactory. Let's go back.
Yes, Victoria, you still...
Excuse me, Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes. Excuse me.
No, Victoria. Excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing me.
You'd never allow that?
I'm on top of it. I think John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans.
Wow, I'm a walking dictionary.
All the right answers. Good. Make sure you finish working on it by today. I have faith in you.
By today? Seriously? I've got a whole week to submit it. I don't know how long it takes for this submission to propagate all the way to wherever it is that convention is taking place. Hold right trigger to move faster. AKA run. But not really run, because you're jogging. Let's go.
Okay, Max, retrace every step.
Just lock the door.
I washed my face. I shredded my phone. Then a butterfly flew in. And I took a photo.
Yeah, no, none of this would happen if you just locked that door.
I can tell everybody they press got a punk ass and begs like a little girl and talks to himself.
You know who the fuck I am.
Yeah, let's not go there. So, I grabbed the hammer.
No way!
Don't ever touch me again, freak!
Dang.
Another shitty day.
That did not happen. This cannot be real.
Also, I put my hand on that buzzer. Wait. Wait, did he take the weapon with him? Also, why are these doors open? I just want to know everything. Anything and everything I can know, I want to know. But I suppose if I'm still in here, the plot will not progress. So, I'd better get a move on. Possibly hiding.
Situation is under control. There's no emergency here. Leave Miss Caulfield alone and please turn off that alarm since that's your job.
Okay. Well, I'll just be going now. Bye. That alarm, that wasn't me. Nothing to worry about.
Are you okay?
I'm just a little worried about my future.
You're sweating pinballs. Is that all you're thinking about? You can always be a fuck. Or have you done something?
Really?
Is that it? Well, Max, talk to me.
Damn.
I just got sick in class. Female charges.
Except they're wandering around like a zombie. And do you think that's the first time a student has used that line on me?
It's the truth. I felt dizzy in Mr. Jefferson.
Just tell me what you're hiding. You can trust us.
I can trust you.
I got sick. It happens, you know.
There's that team too to give you. I've heard of. Don't think I don't know what goes on around here. You've only been here for 3 weeks, and you're already causing conflict.
Oh, great.
I hope your parents will approve when they find out. Now get outside in class. Please.
No, he does not hide that at all.
Wander around here. Get on outside. Don't wander around here. Get on outside.
What if I don't want to go outside? What if I want to trip the fire alarm again? And let's go. It's beautiful outside, and yet I'm going to be all mopey and say, you know, I can't take a picture, and there's nothing heroic to take pictures of. I mean, look, there's a statue there. I'm sure whoever that statue is of is some kind of hero in somebody's eyes. Otherwise, why would there be the statue? Wait. Can I... Thank you. Here I'm strafing about. Let's take a look. Okie dokie. Sure.
Okay, I better get to my room and grab that flashlight.
Yeah, well, let's take some photos first. And talk to everybody out here. Sup, Brooke?
Hi, Brooke. Let me guess. You want to fly my drone?
No. Is that a euphemism for something?
Is that even legal?
Of course.
Nobody knows about that.
Too many conspiracies.
It depends on the drone, really.
Funny. Warren said you were smart. Please, step back.
That was mean. Is that really necessary?
Hi, Brent. Let me guess. You want to fly my drone?
That's not the only thing I mean. Yeah, that'd be great.
This is needed. Do you know what a drone really is?
Weapon, right?
You read too many conspiracy sites. This might be too complicated for you. Funny.
I suppose I don't get a chance here, do I? Wait, can I go back and perhaps just observe her flying it?
Cook actually has a drone. Cook actually has a drone.
Whatever. It's not drone on. Oh.
What a complicated name for such a tiny drone.
Dude, it's the branding that and the marketing which causes things to be so expensive. Flattery gets you everywhere, except when it doesn't.
Drones are perfect for that, especially those with great range. It's a new era of energy.
Most impressive, Max. Warren said you were multifaceted. Here, get the drone tomorrow around campus.
Don't mind if I do. Wait. How do I control this thing? Oh, it's... Okay, I don't get to control it. Because that would be completely crazy if I got drone physics. Well, that looks cool, though. So, let's chat again.
I bet David Matson would love to spy on us with this kind of drone.
Here. Get the drone world around campus.
So, I mean, it's cool and all, but I get to see things from a drone's point of view. Apparently, school mascot is the Bigfoot. That's what it would look like if you were to climb the tree and then jump from the tree. And yeah, here I'm doing all kinds of tricks and stunts and stuff with it. Still, it is kind of cool to see things from a bird's eye point of view. And the loop repeats. Oh, that's right. I can run if I really want to. What's up, Aiden?
Hey,
there she is! The retro selfie master.
That's me, alright. You look relaxed as usual, Aiden.
It's a skill one cultivates at Blackwell, especially when one represents the Vortex Club.
Wait, who's in this club?
What the hell is the Vortex Club anyway? It seems so elitist.
Only if you're not cool enough to get in.
If you say so.
Well, I mean, yeah, being in clubs is generally a good thing for the resume.
You mean him with a Vortex Club? That sounds like the setup to a horrible prank.
Chillax, paranoid bro. We're not that desperate for fun. We know how to do that on our own.
It seems weird to think about partying with all those Rachel Amber posters.
You're high. Rachel used to hang out with us too. She's a blast. Smart, not what she was.
So where's Rachel?
I knew she liked the party. Fun to be around. Oh yeah, she was hot.
Really? Okay, so I could ask just about everything here.
Did Victoria like Rachel? She seems like the jealous type.
Don't you know Victoria so well? She suspected Rachel. Maybe if she didn't act like
what? Well, that's kind of weird.
Rachel was actually a member of the Vortex Club?
No. Rachel was like her own club. She was actually too cool for us.
Really? Yeah, now you're confusing me.
Whatever happens to people who disappear without a trace?
Oh, yeah, so you guys are all responsible and stuff. And participating in your club is no risk, but, you know, one of your club members disappears, or, I mean... Did not dawn on me until now that that chemical could just mean that maybe there's some things he's able to do, given where this Blackwell Academy is located, and given his presumptive age of 18 or greater. I know U.S. smoking laws are like 21, but there might be other chemicals he could do. There's another missing person poster.
Could go for a
burger. Oh yeah. On a quest for magic and adventure, roll the 20-sided dice. Join Blackwell's Science Gamers Group every Wednesday, Blackwell Science Lounge, 3:15. Weekly games to be announced. Just have knowledge of basic gaming rules and etiquette. Don't suck. Cosplay and women also welcome. Okay. Gosh, that reminds me of when, our high school's chess club was trying to be inviting everybody. And we did make a point of being, gender inclusive. And believe it or not, I mean, all our club members were actually upstanding, decent citizens and people, and we did find representation in both genders, which is really unusual for a chess club.
I think his name is Evan. He always looks so... Evan's portfolio always looks so overpro. I'd love to see his photos in
here. Evan, I want to see your photos.
Evan, mind if I check out your whole portfolio?
Let's see if he's worthy of it.
Oh, really? Okay, Google. No.
Robert Capa, of course. I love his work,
yeah.
Despite the controversy about that photo.
My.
This quiet child knows this.
That's why I'm here.
You're a kindred spirit, Max.
Would you care for a perusal of my portfolio?
I just said I want to see your damn portfolio. Stop acting so special. And just let me read your damn thing. Or see it. Huh. Mesmerizing, you say. I just happened to read a book, Artemis Fowl, not too long ago. And now I understand the meaning of the word mesmer. So mesmerizing is kind of a strong word to use for a photo.
Hello?
Max, I don't feel like talking.
What's wrong?
Nathan Prescott, little rich bitch kid. He thinks he can own people like his parents own Blackwell. Like he owns the Vortex Club.
Yes, he's a nasty.
Okay. I should stay politically correct here.
It'll happen. Karma doesn't play payback.
Yeah, history always proves that, right? Just wait for justice.
Really?
Let's talk later, okay, Max?
Let's try this conversation one more time, maybe?
later, okay, Max?
Can I be all passive aggressive?
Hello?
Max, I don't feel like talking.
That's wrong.
Nathan Prescott, little rich bitch.
Yes, he's a nasty piece of work.
Somebody needs to take that prick down.
He'll take himself down.
Yeah, history always proves that, right?
Yeah. Yep.
Clever.
Wait, what's so clever? Oh. Yeah, that's really clever. It involves a vortex. And it looks... Okay. Oh. So we got the school on the one side of the street. Or I guess the academy over here. And then we got this big old sports field on the other. It makes a great deal of sense. From the perspective of being able to get people in and out of the venue, it's really practical engineering-wise, but you're never going to find a place where... Well, I shouldn't say that. There might be some. But how crazy is it to have, like, a four-lane road between... This is a four-lane road, right? So, I'm going to stand in your way. I'm going to try to stop you from doing all the tricks. No, but, but yeah, it looks like at least a multi-lane road separating the academy from the sports fields. That seems unrealistic. The academy's schools and so forth tend to prefer having their sports fields as close to the facility as possible. Just to show, so that when people are on tour, they can show off the amazing sports stuff.
I'm sure this poster has stopped annoying people.
Wait, what? Multitasking keeps you busy, but not alive. Social media is no replacement for reality. Come visit the Buddhist Center. Yeah, where we replace your reality. Bully much? No bully thinks they're a bully. So think about that before you bully. If you think before you become a bully, go to bullyforyou.org. We'll stand up for you. Oh, and then there's Kate Marsh, looking for to join fellow Christians to read and discuss. See, that's polite and respectful. Everybody's entitled to their freedom of doing that sort of stuff. They can be wrong. They could be right.
Lauren's waiting for me and his flash drive in the parking lot, so I better get back to him
tomorrow. Okay. Hey, look, a signpost.
Now I have to go back to the dorm. This day never ends.
Yep. Where is my dorm? I'm sure if I just jog about, I'll find it. I wonder, is this it across the quad here? Wait, can I not walk there myself? Fine. Let's teleport. Walking's for plebeians. Also, suddenly everybody... Well, no, there's still some people out. I was gonna say suddenly everybody just left. But Warren's still waiting for us. Wait, what's this? Damn straight he does. Or they do. Yeah. We're busy throwing a ball. Kate. What's up, Kate?
Glad to see your campus is easy to friend.
What's up?
Hey, Max.
You look down. You okay?
I'm kind of over humanity today. Sorry to be a drama queen.
Is there anything...
Sorry to be a drama queen. I'm just gonna go off by myself.
Max, get the food. Seriously, Max, I don't want to talk.
Now you say that.
Max, get the food.
Meanwhile, you say you want to have a Bible study group. And yet, you're saying, I don't want to talk with anybody.
This is going to be too damn cute.
Squirrel! Squirrel! Yeah, now there's your hero. Actually, here's a hero, Samuel.
Hi, Samuel.
Just doing his work.
Hello there.
What's up with these Rachel Amber posters? I guess.
What?
It just makes the campus look sad.
You can't come over there, sunlight.
So, you're gonna tell the janitor that he should go take down all the posters just because you don't know what's up with them. Alright. Really?
What was she like? She must have been popular.
Even sunlight can cast shadows.
Even sunlight can cast shadows. Okay. You don't understand science very well. Sunlight doesn't cast shadows. And just because batteries have positive and negative polarities doesn't mean that they're actual, like, positive, like, protons and anti-protons and stuff. Whatever. Okay. Can I take a picture of Samuel being all heroic? Just doing his daily job as a model citizen. Ooh. There's a ladder, there's some paint, there's...
If you think of all the rain here in Oregon, you wouldn't need to water the lawn. I guess Blackwell has to take the lawn and plants well manicured to look good on the catalog. I feel like Alyssa and I should be better friends.
Hi, Max.
What are you reading?
Love today or die forever. Don't even...
Wait, who wrote that one?
It's a bestseller. What to say?
Really?
Good point. Now it's no excuse me.
Okay.
Sorry. I really have to find out what happens.
Sorry, I really got to find out what happened. Okay, so, what's this over here?
Glad to see our campus is even better.
Another garbage disposal unit.
Oh, shit. There is Victoria in her meeting rooms.
Okay.
Oh, look. It's Max Caulfield. The selfie held Blackwell.
Damn straight. I mean...
What a lame gimmick. Even Mark, Mr. Jefferson, falls for your weight hipster bullshit. The Daguerrean processor. You could barely even say that. I guess you got your meds filled.
Can't you guys just leave me alone?
Since you know all the answers, I guess you have to find another way into the dorm. We ain't living. Oh, wait. Hold up, host. So original. Don't worry, Max. I'll put a vintage filter on it right before I post it all over social media. Now, why don't you go fuck yourself?
Oh, yes, Victoria. I'll get your phone.
Damn. That was really clever. And original. Okay.
I could crank a sprinkler up and give Victoria and her clones incentive to do it. I don't want to mess with that line on her horse name. I just want to get Victoria the hell out of the way. Do you understand English? Get lost.
No. You get lost. Okay, fine. So these sprinklers, I think, are hooked up back here, right? Oh, look, it's... Sure.
This main sprinkler valve looks easy enough to use.
Wait. Can I take a picture of it? Why can't I take pictures of everything? You're saying it looks easy enough to use. And yet, the only thing I can do is just look at it. Okay, so... Are you saying...
There's only one way out.
Okay, so I have to go back. You're saying I gotta go back. Well, let's use it. Sure, why not?
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this. Jill Victoria, just water. Yeah, water on my cashmere. Do you know how much this fucking outfit costs?
You look great. Well, why did you buy it then? Why did you buy it if you're... I mean, you shouldn't be wearing it outside. Here, let's have some fun with the bucket, too.
Okay, let's see if this works.
Wait. I want to, like, approach all of these girls and... Yeah, physics doesn't work that way, by the way. Wow, I got Samuel in trouble. Okay. Yeah, sure. So, how's it going, Victoria? Okay. And I kind of ruined it.
It was.
So.
But there will be another. Well, you always seem to know.
Yeah, a game doesn't allow you to walk through it somehow.
I do it sometime. Mr. Jefferson told me. I've seen the pictures. You have a great art. Richard Avedon is. He's one of my heroes. Thanks, Max. I hope those sluts get me a towel before they make me sign on me.
Well,
you deserve a better shot. Sorry about blocking you and the go fuck yourself. That was me.
I don't know. Do I really deserve a better shot?
One of those days, you know?
I
know
exactly. Could it just...
I'll see you later.
I mean, any shot you take of me is going to look awesome, so...
Victoria probably played me. I should have played her. Better get to my room before I find Warren.
Sorry. I really have to find out what happened.
What's this?
Don't take it out on the tree, loser.
Rachel owes me money. Okay. Who's this me who carved that into the tree? Really, there's only one student who could have gotten away with that kind of stuff. But at least it's good that that student's taking it out on a tree and not taking it out on Rachel. Still, it's like these students think they own the world or something. And maybe some of them do. And maybe they're right, but still, I guess if you're right, then it can't hurt you that much to have that kind of mentality. But the world is so much more interesting if you don't have that mentality, if you have to share it with people.
Room 217. No way in hell am I ever
going to be here. Redrum. Yeah, she is. Why'd you take so long?
Blackwell isn't that big, but sure feels like a labyrinth.
Maybe because it is a labyrinth? Let's read this. HIV and AIDS aren't just initials on a poster. These are serious, life-threatening diseases, and nobody is immune from exposure. Get the facts now. Reward. On September 16th, just 2 weeks ago, my backpack with all my school books and my new tablet was taken from the cafeteria after I left it on the table. There are invaluable images of my late cats. so I would appreciate the quick return of my possessions and feline memories. You have my address. Wait, we saw another poster elsewhere in the school saying there was a laptop for sale with 5 gigabytes of cat. Great. Okay. So, to the bitch that stole my Franju New Face cream. That was expensive shit, and I need it for my acne. I know exactly how it exfoliates, and I'll be watching your skin the second it clears up. Okay.
Is this a Vortex Club or a Victoria Club machine? As if. Juliet, extreme reporter.
Oh. So you're saying that other alarm, the one we saw in the main school room, is more dated. Huh. Did not know that.
Yeah.
Social media has a time and place. Don't let life flash you by. A message from the Clearhead Foundation.
Okay, this is just mean and stupid.
Wait, what's this? Oh. Yeah. Let's try something less offensive. Can I take a picture?
The universal symbol for please leave me alone. This is like the public DNA of a world.
Don't let depression keep you down. Everyone gets sad and lonely, blah blah blah. Lost phone. Diamond phone case. Like, made of actual diamond. Statistics tutor wanted. Help. It's been almost a month and I still don't understand. Help. We'll pay if you give me an A. Courtney W. Wait. That Courtney? She's not that dumb, is she?
Oh, Victoria, give me a fucking break.
Be the change you want. Okay. Wait. Is that even correct? Be the change you wish to see. Okay, yeah, that is correct.
But what's this poster really trying to tell me?
This is your planet, and when it comes to protecting the environment, you're the boss. Okay. Save the Earth. Save the planet. Save the squirrels.
Warren should be all over them. They're perfect for each
other. Well, yeah. Pie. The forks. Alright, what else can we see here? Is there anything on this? Nope. Let's not go back outside. It's my room.
How sad. I didn't write anything. I have nothing to say.
No, you've got something to say. Everybody's got something. Okay. See?
Obvious, but true.
I hope somebody else improves upon that, because that's kind of sad.
Dana is still a cheerleader at heart. Man, people here are monsters.
Oh, I could navigate through these. Young guns training. Even though you can't have guns, you can still learn how to op. Okay. Safe, not sorry. You have a choice. Okay. Yeah, so what happened to this other poster board over here?
This girl must have been popular. She's everywhere.
I'm totally not jealous of that. Be alert on campus. Always be aware of your location. Always let a friend know where you're going. Always report any incident immediately to the campus authorities. To download a free campus alert app, go there. A book club. Wait. For sale, a bicycle. It'll lead you anywhere. $20, and if you pay $5 extra, they'll actually deliver the bike to you, so you never have to ride it. And there's no helmet included. Okay. Geek GRRLS book club. No boy wizards and no vampire fictions allowed. No boys.
Thanks for the warning.
Yeah, yep. So. Wait. Oh. Shower room's being cleaned up. I like how I could see out the window here. Like, if I pan the camera, you get the multi-layered background panning. I forget what that effect's called. But, you can see that the window moves, and the background moves even more with respect to the camera. So it's like vanishing point perspective, but in motion. So I should probably go to my room, considering that Warren's been waiting for like 5 hours for me to give him back his flash drive. So I'll just go back here and pick it up and just head out with no incident whatsoever.
Home sweet home, my favorite cocoon.
I mean, we are playing the role of an 18-year-old girl, so who knows what we'll encounter, right?
I love that Mom sent me a back box of chocolate coconut bites for my birthday.
Oh. Left back button to get to my journal. Your principal sent me an email saying that he's concerned about your attitude and behavior, and that you're not fitting in well and hiding in your dorm. Yeah, that's not true. I know it's hard to be away from your home, even if you're all grown up now, but you are there to change the world with your camera. Please call me soon. Blah, 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 blah. Okay. Cookies. Nice. What else do we got? Never forget the day you were born and your first smile. It was love at first sight. It was your special day. We miss you. We're so proud. Yep. Okay, let's take a look at that. That looks remarkably sparse. Just saying. Man Ray? Who would that be? Like, honestly, I don't know.
It's such a pretty guitar. I need to play it
while. Yeah, let's play it while Aaron's waiting. He said he's been waiting and waiting and waiting and wants the drive back. No. Huh. Well, that looks lovely, doesn't it? Plus, to your remark about the game being anti-male, I don't know, there are, there's definitely hostility, as you'd expect to see, between both genders. And it's not just one versus the other. Both are actively, aggressive in their own ways. Well, I sure learned a lot playing that. Hey, what's this?
I'm glad Kate let me borrow her copy of the October Country. I should have every Bradbury book for myself.
Yeah, you should. How else are you going to be all hipster? But, can I take a look at this? There we go. We look.
Film is so damn hard to find and expensive. Though. But I can't help it. I'm analog, not digital. Instant film is so damn hard.
Oh, instant film meaning thing that you're putting into the Polaroid camera. Yeah, no. It's going to be a long time before digital cameras can capture what analog cameras can.
If I'm not looking through a viewfinder, I'm looking through a window. Always the same.
I mean, you think that digital photos have great resolution. They really don't. Actual photos is where it's at.
You are thirsty. I'm the worst baby mama. Drink up.
This action will have consequences.
I haven't forgotten you, Mona Lisa. Yet. One day I'll organize my film collection. One day I'll get an actual HDTV. Looks like they might have been a little bit.
Hey, Errol. I borrowed your drive, so I can watch some films while I study. If you need it back, just track me down in my room. D. It's totally not a fetch quest.
Philip Lorca de Portia? Man. I don't think I could take my camera to places. Look at that shot. I love Julia Cameron's Victoria vibe. Talk about animal cameras. Ah, what a fantastic eye. He could truly freeze time.
I do definitely appreciate when people have that kind of passion. It's too bad we can't get good samples of what those pictures look like, although they're copyrighted or subject. All the pictures are copyrighted of those famous works. Okay. Yeah. Yep, look at all that camera porn. Warren Graham. Max, thanks for your email and copy of Jefferson's class notes. Now, I shall never stop sending you messages of gratitude. I also have a rather eclectic collection of TV, cult, classic, and effed up films on a fat flash drive if you ever want to check them out. Thanks again for the help. I'm a scientist more than an artist. Now, can you quickly explain to me how a camera... Warren, no. Oh my goodness, you're the worst scientist ever. Just, no. No, no, no. You suck at science, but somehow you're still smart. Okay.
That's the only tourist picture I've ever taken of me at the space needle. That was a good hot thing and a great ride. Man, Kristen and Fernando were so drunk hanging on the 3 month roll. Max and Chloe, best friends forever. I'm going to have to call Chloe eventually and find out what she'll say. The longer I wait, the worse it'll be. Idiot.
Yeah, you're an idiot. But, so call her now. Like, can... just go ahead, call her.
I should hit the thrift store and pick up some dollar vinyl. Is that too hipster? I don't know. Music inspires me in my photography.
Does it? But you didn't know about the Daguerrean process. You had to time travel to find out about that one.
So cheesy, but it makes me smile thinking of the day Mama and I sewed that together.
Yep, I'm just gonna lay here and leave Warren.
Maybe I'll just wake up now and find out I was dreaming all of this.
That's what I was saying. That's what I was saying. But yeah, while we're just here lounging about, enjoying the fact that Dana stole our flash drive, which isn't even ours, it's really Warren's. So she, like, broke and entered into our room, stole the flash drive, which didn't even belong to us. And now we've got to go retrieve it. And while I'm just lounging about here saying, you know, I'm not going to worry about any of that. not going to call my friend Chloe, who I've been waiting on and not calling for the last month. And I'm just going to sit here and do nothing. And look at that smoke alarm. Or smoke detector. Okay, let's get up and actually do something. Chop chop. Wait, what's this?
Max Caulfield Photo Memorial Wall.
Yeah, there's some empty spaces in that wall.
Ahoy, Captain. At least I know you've got my back. When I was dying and my parents rushed me to the ER, I knew you were bonded forever.
Yeah. Turns out that bear... Wait. Oh, I can turn off and on the lights.
Max Caulfield Photo Memorial.
Let's take a look.
I believe I'm 18. Do I look any older? Just more stressed.
Yeah. Also, I mean, for all the time you talk with and hang out with other people, you've only got selfies. I mean, as far as this Blackwell Academy is concerned, it's just about you. But okay, we need to go track down Dana. Ask why did... Looks like Dana's good at making friends. Let's see what she's up to. Fetch quest initiate! Oh, cool. So, what other kind of satanic rituals do you participate in?
No, probably not. How did you find out?
Why do you care? Why are you even asking me? You never talk. Just zone out with your camera.
That's why I'm talking to you now.
What's my last name?
Juliet Watson.
Good for you.
Just because I don't talk a lot doesn't mean I don't care. So, how did you find out about them?
According to Victoria, Dana would do anything to date a quarterback.
According to Victoria.
So now it's about a quarterback, huh?
She saw the sex.
I'll give you a quarterback.
And Catherine won't answer his phone. Once Dana admits it, she can go. Straight to hell.
Oh. Oh, okay. As long as that's all it is. Oh, you're so moody. Oh, so moody. Alright. So, we gotta find something. Somehow convince Juliet, what's her name, that we actually care about her. That things are A-okay. That she's got nothing to worry about. Alright, let's hop in here. Have some fun. Enter. Yeah. But. Huh. Wait, can I not take a photo?
Let's play a little photo Tetris and leave Victoria a message. Let's move this here. And this one there.
A pattern is emerging. Hey. But we get to take a photo. After we were so nice to Victoria outside, we did that to her. And why not?
Oh, I had no idea Victoria's parents owned the Chase space.
Chase space? Oh, it must be a building. Of Blackwell.
She's actually got a classic medium format camera with some awesome prime lens. I hate it, Victoria. No.
Let's take a look.
Is she going to get a 3D printer for her dorm room? Maybe I will join her process.
Create your future. Jump into the 22nd century with a Tezuka 3D desktop printer. Design and produce your vision. Order today. Be prepared for tomorrow. Yeah, because 3D printer is going to do a photographer so much good. Ooh, can I take some jewelry? Well, no, I guess that'd be obvious if I took it. Ooh, a sticker.
Yes, I get it. Enter the Vortex Club. No.
What's up with all these cushions and stuff? Having a sofa and a bed and a TV.
That is a tasty plaza. Maybe I can sneak in and watch Final Fantasy Spirits with them.
Hey, if we could find the flash drive, we could do that.
That's one of the best sci-fi films ever made.
Yeah, what about Spirited Away? Well, it's not a sci-fi. Oh. I should have paid attention. What did you say?
I bet Victoria put Juliet on her ship list after this article.
By Juliet Watson. Oh. So maybe Victoria's not so happy with Juliet. Is the Vortex Club a cult? You think? Really? I mean, unless it's a religion, I'm pretty sure that it's a cult. One of Blackwell... Oh, let me read it this way. One of Blackwell's most durable and influential social groups, the Vortex Club, started in the neon 1980s as a new wave rebellion against the yuppie forces of the Reagan era. Imagine a time when computer nerds were dumped into garbage cans and blue hair was a cause for expulsion and even violence. Male students who wore earrings were bullied and beaten. Now every football player has two or three exotic piercings. So the Vortex Club was originally a haven from the peer pressure that every generation experiences. How ironic that then the revolutionary roots of social misfits have become what some students claim is an elitist cult. Or is this just envy at one of Blackmail's most successful organizations? We tried to interview Vortex Club member Rod Victoria Chase, but she refused to comment and even tried to stop this story from publication. Okay, interesting opinion piece. Why the heck would you publish it? It's great to provide the historical information, but unless you're, like, publishing for Gawker or something, there's no reason to ask questions that slander people. And even if you are Gawker, you probably shouldn't be doing that.
Victoria is a real Jefferson's
Ruby. Recollection. As opposed to recollection? Okay. What is that photo? I can't even tell. It's like an outdoor snack. I don't know. Salvador Dali would be proud how confusing that was. Ooh, a missing person poster.
Victoria hates Rachel Amber this much.
Oh.
How insecure.
Oh. That's not cool. I wanted to take a picture of that wanted poster, though. The whole who cares and everything. The Bean Hip Cafe. Bring the ad for $1 off. Dude, I'm stealing this. I'm gonna... Actually, why does Victoria need this for? I'm the one who needs to save money, not her.
Yes, Victoria has the best Retina screen laptop.
Well, we've already...
Let me just check to see if she posted my picture. I'll give Victoria props for not posting my photo. And for this nice shot.
Well, yeah.
Boom. This is the email I'm gonna show you yet. Now I have to print this fast and get the hell out of here.
Or use my special time power. Taylor, so sad to inform you that I totally punked Juliet and Dana just now. All I had to do was mention to Juliet that I saw a nasty sext from Dana on Zach's phone. Dumbass believed me, and so I expect there to be some dorm rampage soon. Juliet deserves this for slutting Zach away from me. As for Dana, who cares? Get out your popcorn. Yeah, that's just a little bit callous, I'll say. But seriously, is there nothing in this room that I want to take before I leave? Not even a picture.
They should call this series Blue. Cold and soulless. Kind of like Victoria.
I mean... You say that like it's a bad thing. Oh, okay. So yeah, I did do one thing before I left. Actually, I could just leave this in the printer and not take it. Or I could print another one. And just print tons of these and take them all over the school.
This better convince Juliet that Dana is innocent.
Can I print another, please? No, I can't. I would totally do it and put them up all over the school, but...
I bet Victoria put Juliet on her shit list after this article.
Yeah. Well, I guess that's the reason for so much bad blood between the two. They're both trying to slander or ruin each other's lives, so... Let's leave. Alright, and I'll take this poster, or take this printed material and just hang it up somewhere. Or do the responsible thing. The thing that advances the plot. The thing that continues the fetch quest. What's this?
Looks like nobody won this TT war. There's nothing left but both.
Okay. Why would there be a TP war in a girl's women's dorm room? I don't get it.
Juliet, read this.
Of course. I'm an asshole. I'm sorry, Rina.
You are. And I hope so. You really think I mess around with that, right?
But I get stupid jealous. I owe you dinner. Still lovely?
And you be my mom.
Thanks, Matt. You're like a black blood ninja. Now let's see
yeah.
what Dad has to say about Victoria.
You set me free. Thank you. Warren's flash drive is on my desk.
Oh, that's all I get? That's all you're gonna give me. Yeah, just
almost.
Give me my.
Get the flash drive, and then I'll go see Warren.
Come on, can you, like, recompense me for my effort? Please?
Hey, Dana.
Can we at least talk?
Thanks again. I can't believe Juliet locked me in my own room. Real mature.
Also, how do you lock somebody in their room? Aren't the locks supposed to keep people out, not in? What's wrong with Blackwell? So, Victoria's not nice. Juliet gets her rage on. And
poor Juliet gets her rage on. I hope she doesn't kill Victoria. Zachary should worry, too. As if I'd let that ego-case jockstrap touch me. But I bet Victoria would be all over that. Or has been. Max, you're
wait,
so
what?
Though Warren obviously likes him.
What? The what? What are you talking about?
He's a good guy. A geek like me. You saw the files on his flash drive. Tons of crazy shit. Films I've never even heard of. And in a special folder called Max.
Yeah, okay.
I got you. Are you blushing? Go ahead and grab the flash drive.
But also, I mean, you're all about sports. You like the whole cheerleading thing. And yet, you claim that you don't want to be with Zach. What the heck is wrong with you? No, seriously, what's wrong with you?
It would be a cool sticker without the words.
Who wouldn't want to be with Zach? Dana, I suck at writing, but I thought I should write this, so you might not hate my dumbass forever. I know I act like a tough jock around everybody. I never had to act around you. I'm not that kind of man you deserve. You saw how I pushed out. If you need any money, let me know. Logan. Okay. Hope money's not a code talk for... Okay, let's see. Next thing.
This is both sad and
next thing. You've already looked at that.
Ooh, Dana's Facebook wall is up and running. Of course a popular cheerleader like Dana would have a million friends.
Well, duh.
So fascinating to get a peek at Dana's social media world. And this Max is so terribly wrong.
Oh. Apparently, sharing with people is so terribly wrong. Trevor. Hey, what up, Dana? Justin couch looked as Super Mario. Really? If you want to come over, we can blaze and play or go for a walk. let me still know I'll be here. Still here? Hello? Yeah, whatever. And I suppose I should just take the flash drive, though. Let's look at it. There it is. Yep, still there. Oh, yeah. Okay, we'll take it. It's not even yours. It's Warren's. It's not your precious. Wait a minute. So this is Dana's bed, I presume. I guess this entire room... I'm sorry, yeah, these must be one student to a room. I'm really slow at connecting the dots on that one. But, yeah, just one person to a room. So, now that's Dana's room. Is there anything else we can do? Can we trigger the fire alarm? We cannot trigger the fire alarm. Okay. Can't go to the showers, because that's all cut off. I guess we should go outside. Oh, hey look, we got a message from Warren. I don't mind waiting out here forever. I love this parking lot. I can count all the cars. The more I text, the longer I take. On my way. Just kidding. I'm gonna leave you out there to count all the cars. Because you're being a jerk and saying you enjoy doing it. So I'm just gonna take my time and look at everything out here. Hey look, free football.
I better rewind.
Wait, I want the football. Can I take the... No, okay, fine. But that hurt Alyssa, didn't it? Yeah. That'll show you to keep reading and not be aware of circumstances around you. Did you even read all the posters? They say, like, be careful about where you are and be aware and alert. And you couldn't even do that, could you? Okay, but enough victim blaming. Let's be Alyssa's friend.
Alyssa, move your head.
If you insist, Max.
Now that's what I'm talking about. I actually helped somebody.
This action will have consequences.
Thank you.
Okay, can we talk now?
That was close.
Just you asshole. If I was a member of the Vortex Club, they'd never pull that back.
Would you want to be a member?
You're smart.
Actually, you know, he's like got all upset and chucked the football at the ground. I'm pretty sure he didn't intentionally aim it at you, and he probably would have done that regardless of whether you were in the club. You sure?
I could almost feel sorry for him if he wasn't such a serious dick. I'll show you that.
Yep. Graffiti's still there. Wait, what's that? I don't know what that is up there. But let's keep Warren waiting as long as possible and take some scenic tour of the grounds. Oh, I can actually walk out here. I thought the game was going to say, no, this is too far off the path. You can't go there. Apparently, I have trouble climbing hills, but... the game does allow me some freedom of movement, which is pretty nice. Or at least the illusion of freedom. But we'll take it. I already explored this here earlier and we saw a squirrel last time we were here. I see this is closed. That must be another alarm. Why would that alarm be outside? I mean, what good is it doing it there? Unless that's actually a smoke detector. But why would there be smoke outside, and how would it even get detected? I mean, how effective is an outdoor smoke alarm anyway? Let's see, where do you... Well, duh. Yeah, that's the whole purpose to it, is so you can peek in on people's gossip and have fun with it. Oh. Yeah, no, the tree back here. We checked this out earlier. Rachel owes me money. Pay up.
Don't take it out on the tree,
loser. Yeah. Why would you... I mean, that tree's been around so many years. And you just ruined it. Now they're going to have to cut the tree down and put a new one in its place. And it's all your fault. And if that ruins the planet... Well... Yeah, maybe Rachel should have just paid up. Maybe it's not your fault.
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here in black. Do you understand what I'm saying?
And leave me alone.
Well, as one famous photographer said, always take the shot. Let's take a shot. Take a photo.
You can't fool me. I know everything about this school. I cover the waterfront, so you better figure out what side you're on.
Oh, the other tree? Yeah, I don't know. I didn't see anything on the other tree. And unfortunately, at this point, it's too late to go back. I think. Do you understand that you're not the only person in this world? Do you understand that, like... Yeah, that security guard. That security guard, David Manson... He's quite angry at me, too. I mean, he's just, like, angry at everybody. He really... Oh, okay. So there's actually something here. Mike Art, not War. That's cool. Can I take a photo of that? Actually, can I submit that photo of David Manson? Basically interrogating a student. Security officer getting all up in a student's face. Could I submit that to the Everyday Heroes contest? Because I would love to do that. That'd be a great photo. Yeah. Cool. Thanks for pointing that out. I missed it. Now... Surprisingly, the area in front of the dorm is all vacant, but the area in front of the academy is bustling with activity. I don't understand that. I mean, who identifies with the building of that's a place of learning? People tend to more identify with their dorm or their sports arena or their cafeteria or other places, but... Yeah, you should. I mean... Okay, if you say so. Let's see. Is there anything else worth seeing out here? Sorry that I keep getting disoriented. I need to do a I need to flip the vertical controls. Cars equals death. You're not wrong. For some people. But yeah, TPing a bike seems really ineffective. Wow, what a junkmobile. What does this say? TWRRKS. Okay. That's cool.
Now this just really pisses me off. So entitled.
Yeah.
My truck needs these two spots more than we do.
Wait, what's that? Oh, pile of missing person posters. Okay. Can I take a picture of this everyday hero? I will need something to submit to the contest. What else is out here? How much more can I procrastinate? Oh.
That dog looks peaceful asleep, but if I get too close,
Cujo. Yeah, no kidding.
That layer of dust is begging
That's what she said. I so dirty.
I could use this picture for a series on Arcadia Bay Lots.
Okay, what else is out here? Anything? THSPRNS.
The whole town is turning into one giant missing persons poster.
Well, hopefully they'll find her soon. And hopefully she's alright.
A new surveillance system. That's how it starts.
Over the past few months, there have been multiple break-ins of faculty and student vehicles in the Blackwell parking lot. A new surveillance system is being installed, but you should make sure your vehicle is always secure and locked. He's a security officer. At least he doesn't overrepresent his title. As opposed to saying, like, security, god, administrator, or something. THLCHTZN. Wait, no, TWL. CHTZN. I don't get it. I know somebody once figured out what those are all for. Can't see that one. Hey, look, a bird. Can I take a picture of the bird? I want a picture of the bird. Let me take a picture, please. There's Warren. He's... That was funny. You remember that message he sent us earlier. Let me just reread that, if I may. Let's see. Yeah. See this here? I don't mind waiting out here forever. I love this parking lot. I can count all the cars. You know, he makes such a big deal of that. You know, we're going to count all the cars. One, two, three. Oh, hey, look, there's Juliet. How's it hanging?
How are you doing?
Oh, hey, man. Sorry, I'm so screwed up.
Sorry you had to find out about Zachary that way. Or any way.
Better sooner than later. Now that skank Victoria won't be laughing behind my back anymore.
Have you talked to Zach yet?
Mr. Badass football hero is such a chicken. He said he likes to Victoria in a show. Ha ha.
Oh, that's great.
He usually does. And then you join him.
Yeah, seriously, people need to get over the concept that the game's all about them. Because I'm the main character, the game's all about me. Me, and nobody else. Okay, so let's get back to counting. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's go run next to each one of them, just to make sure we counted them accurately. 5, 6, 7. 8, 9, 10, 11. I think I already counted that one. 12. So that's something like 12 or 13 cars here. Let me just go back here, see if I can fit them all in the shot, and just do a quick recount. So there's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Alright, Warren, quiz question. How many cars are there?
What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978 to be exact. Now we can go to the driveway. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
Oh boy, that sounds fun.
But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange
see a photo of that.
Oh, I should have taken a photo.
I don't want to talk about it.
Jeez, you're a little sensitive today.
I wouldn't push your luck, Laura. Not in the mood today.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie video on my flash drive?
Yeah, thanks. You got some cool shit on there. From Akira to Twilight Zone, which seems apropos today.
Ooh, look, I can use words like apropos.
Cultural pirate connoisseur.
That does sound better than the thief.
Ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
Yeah, I already watched it.
I was more disturbed by all those emo vampire movies in there.
Can a sensitive high school boy love sensitive vampires too?
So you're sensitive.
But you're calling me sensitive.
Russ Mayer was a genius with Black and White. Plus, baby breath.
Who would beat your sensitive ass down?
If I was lucky. Speaking of taking fast, you should come down my car.
Oh, silly boys.
You seem distracted.
I need to talk to somebody. Just to get it out of my system.
Dr. Warren Graham is in the house. I won't even prescribe you any meds. Tell me everything.
Yeah. You're not an actual doctor.
This is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Go on.
I had this incredibly bizarre experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right? One of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of the students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you saw, now.
Okay. Yeah, I'll tell you. I'll tell you. Just any second now, I'll get around to telling you. I hope you're patient. No. I'm just taking a meaningful pause before I speak.
Answer me, bitch.
Yeah, I'll get to it. Hey, you didn't ask me what I heard, you asked me what I saw.
Actually, I have a pretty good idea of who you are.
Do not analyze me! I pay you for it. Worry about yourself, Maxwell.
I could call the police.
Do it! The press got owned the police.
Get away from her, dude!
Oh! You do know that there are surveillance cameras, right? Just saying. Also, don't touch that. It's hot.
No, wait. You again.
Damn. Wait. Wait, how did Stranger Girl know who I am? Oh wait, did I introduce myself? I think I did.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe.
Yeah, I did introduce myself to her. Oh no. Oh no. I apparently have broken the game. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. Makes perfect sense. I'd see you today. It's been that kind of day.
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how did you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend already took a beatdown for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe
Yeah, he loves taking beatdowns. He said so.
And you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet.
Also, what's that noise? Must be my drive.
Cool, but I felt kind of lonely out of my room.
I would think you'd fit right in with art school hipsters.
Right. You look like the cover of hipstergirl.com. At least you're still smart ass. That's why I'm here.
Please, girl. You came back for Black Black Cat.
apologize.
I know things were tough on you when I left.
How do you know? You weren't even here.
I didn't order my parents to move specifically to fuck you over. You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. I just wanted to settle in first.
Actually, I've been here only 3 weeks, Chloe. What's it to you? Plus, there's no way you could have known that. Fourth wall break. I'll just fix my camera and be on my way and never speak with you again.
Come on in, don't be shy.
If you say so.
Nice. Oh, shit.
You're ever the optimist, aren't you, Chloe? Oh, a bird. Man, this game is really scenic.
My room is a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill out zone. My step here, make sure of that. Come in and close the door.
I'm impressed. The game has stereo sound. The graphics are timed with the audio. It's very cool. That said, I'm having technical difficulties here, so I'm going to cut it here. It's been fun. Hope you guys enjoyed it. And we'll be around next time to hopefully finish off episode 1 of Life is Strange. Thanks for watching.